Yes, friends, we are going for the next category of problems. In the previous class, we have seen how to get the maximum bending moment under a given load in a train of loading. When number of loads are moving like this, W1, W2, W3, W4, a number of loads are moving. If I want the maximum bending moment under the load W2, how to analyze it? We have seen it. What we did is it, we calculated the center of gravity or the position of the resultant from one end. Whatever resultant we got the distance between the load under which we want the maximum bending moment and the resultant load, and that distance divided by 2, the point we are getting, and we need to keep that point such that that will coincide with the center of the girder, then only we will get the maximum bending moment under the load 2. Like that, if you want the maximum bending moment under the load 3, what you are doing? You are seeing what is the distance between the load 3 and the resultant, and you are calculating the midpoint of it, center of it. Say this distance is x divided by 2, x by 2. So whatever point you are getting, center point, that should be kept at the center, above the center of the beam, to get the maximum bending moment under the load. This is one category of problem. Now we are going for the second category of problem, wherein we want the maximum bending moment at a given section. Here the section is given to you. Earlier, the section when you want under the given load, by default it will be at the center of the beam. Now he has given you the section. At that section, he wants the maximum bending moment. Most of the cases he is asking this particular category of problem in the examination. That is why you must study it very carefully. Yes. First we see what is the condition for maximum bending moment at a given section. A section is given to you. See, this is what the beam is. Say the beam having certain span, the span of the beam may be anything, 20 meter. He may ask you what is the bending moment at maximum bending moment. I want the train of the loads is moving. You need to decide what is the position of that particular train of loading, so that I want the maximum bending moment at the given section. Section may be at a distance of 5 meter or at a distance of 8 meter or any distance. So the loads, one behind the other, are moving. They are moving like this, one back, one behind the other, and he want picks up the position of the load so that you will get the bending moment at the given section. So what is the basic condition for that one? As I told you, in maximum case you will get this category of problem in the final exam. That is why you need to focus more on this one. For maximum bending moment at any given section, maximum bending moment at a given section occurs when the load crosses the section, changes the average load on the left and right part of the section. What exactly the meaning of this one? The train of the loads are moving one behind the other. The train of the loads are moving one behind the other. Say like this, 100 kN, 120 kN, 150 kN, 160 kN, 80 kN, and the distance between them are 3 meter, 2 meter, and 2 meter like this. 4 loads are there, hence the 3 distances. For example, he wants the maximum bending moment at C. He has given you a girder. The span of the girder is 20 meter. And he is asking you, if these loads are moving, at what position of the load the maximum bending moment occurs at the C, and what is the value of that maximum bending moment? That we need to calculate. Just see how we can calculate it. What he says is, you make the movement of these train of loads to such that they will cross the section one by one. Say I am interested in the maximum bending moment at sea. First you keep all the loads on one side of the sea like this. It all right, first 100, then next this is also 120, 150 and 80. One behind the other they are moving. First assume that the 100 kN, which is nothing but the leading load, crosses the point C, means it is just on the left side of C. Then what is the load on the part CB and what is the load on the part AC? We need to calculate it. What is the load on the part CB is nothing but only 120 is there, 100 is there on this side, and remaining load of 120 plus 150 plus 80, that is nothing but 250, is on the part AC, right? Now you need to calculate the average load on the part BC and the average load on the part AC. See here, the load on the part BC is nothing but when 100 Newton load crosses the point C, the load on the part BC is nothing but 100, only one load is acting on this part, and the distance is 14 meter. Therefore 100 divided by 14 is the average load, that is the total load on the part BC divided by the length BC is the average load on BC. Like that, the total load on the AC divided by the length AC is nothing but the average load on AC. When 100 kN crosses, comes on this side, what are the loads on this side? Only 100. Therefore 100 divided by the distance BC is the average load on BC, and average load on AC is this 120 plus 150 plus 80. That will become equal to, yes, 120 plus 150 plus 80, that is the total load on AC divided by, divide it with the span AC, that is equal to, span AC is 6. Therefore the answer is, this number comes out to be 58.33, and this number comes out to be 100 divided by 14. 100 divided by 14 is 7.14. This is known as the average load on the right part, and this is the average load on the left part. Now you see here, the average load on the left part is greater than the average load on the right part. Is it all right? You need to continue one after the other load till this sign changes. Here actually the load on the left part, right part is less and left part is more. Now you make the next load to cross the section C, means the load is moving like this. First 100 is coming on this side, next 120 comes here. Therefore what is the total load on the part BC is equal to 100 plus 120. 100 plus 120 divided by the span BC is 14. And yes, on this side what is the total load? Yes, it is 150 plus 80. 150 plus 80 divided by span BC. So again you calculate, what is the total load on the part BC divided by the span BC, that is the average load on the right part of C, and calculate the average load on the left part of C. Average load on the left part of C is 80 plus 150 divided by 2. Now see the which is greater one. Earlier the left part was greater and the right part was less. That is why we have written average load on the part AC is greater than the part BC. Next, when 120 kN crosses the section, when 120 kN crosses the section, that time what happens? The average load on the left part becomes 38.33, average load on the right part becomes 15.71. Just see, check it. Again, the left part is greater and the right part is smaller. The same condition you are getting here. Is it all right? Next, you need to continue till this sign reverses, means the average on the right is will become more and the left will become less. This is very important concept. What you need to do, first you start from the total load on one part and make it to move one by one. Calculate the average load on the left part and the right part. If initially the average load on the left part is greater than the average load on the right part, you carry one by one load on the right part till the situation changes. The average load on the right part becomes greater than the average load on the left part. Is it all right? Now you go for, you check it for 100 kN, average load on the right part is less. You check it for next 120 kN, again you got the average load on the right part less than the average load on the left part. Next you go for, let 150 kN crosses the left point C. As we are interested in the maximum minimum at the point C, there only we need to check it, right? Maximum minimum at the point C, there only we need to check it. So, in that case, when 150 kN also crosses, when 150 kN also crosses the section C, when 150 kN load also crosses the section C, when 150 kN load also crosses the section C, that time what happens? The average load on the right part, three loads are there on the right part, 100 plus 120 plus 150. As 150 is, the, we are keeping the load in such a fashion that 150, 120 and 100 are on this side, only 80 is on this side. One thing you need to remember, this order should not be changed. The load as a whole is to be moved. Like you cannot bring 120 back front and 100 back like that. Train of load as it is, it should go, right? So when 120 load crosses the point C, when 120 load crosses the point C, what happens? You just see here, the average load on the right part, left part, only one load is left out on the left part, that is equal to 80 kN. 80 kN divided by span is 6. 80 divided by 6 is the average load on the left part. Then you go for the average load on the right part. Average load on right part. Total load on the right part is 150 plus 120 plus 100 divided by the distance CB, BC. That is nothing but 14. Now you see here, the average load on the right part is becoming 26.42 and 13.33. In this particular condition, just see here. Here, the load on the right part is greater. Here, the load on the left part is greater. This load, this process, whenever change occurs, that load will control the maximum bending moment. Yes, when this particular situation has occurred, when the load of 150 kN just crosses the section C. If that is the case, you need to put the load on the beam such fashion that 150 kN will be at the point where you want the maximum bending moment. As you are interested in the maximum bending moment at the point C, you pick that system of loads, train of loads, and put it in such a manner that 150 kN is over the point C. If 150 is over the point C, then the 120 is at a distance of 2 meter to the right of C, and 100 is at a distance of 5 meter from the right of C, and 80 is from the left of C. This is the position of the load. See here, as crossing of 150 kN changes the sign of the average load on left and right side, 150 kN is to be kept at C for maximum bending moment. Yes, this statement, if I want to generalize it, if I want the maximum bending moment at any section for a given train of loads, I need to change the position of the load. I need to make the load to move from the left to the right. And I need to check the average load on left and the right. The load which leads to the change of the average load on left side to the right side, sign of change, in the change in the sign, in the sense, if it is more on the left side for one load and immediately less on the left side for the other load, that load will become the critical load. That load is to be kept at the point where you want the maximum bending moment. Therefore, the maximum bending moment, the load is to be kept as shown in the figure. Once the position of the load and position of the bending moment where you want the bending moment is fixed, the rest of the problem is very easy for you, right? Yes. Next, the same problem. I'm not completed. I need to calculate the bending moment at the point C. Yes. I'll show the calculation for that. For time being, now for the same train of loads moving, he wants the maximum bending moment. He wants the maximum bending moment at the point C. He wants the maximum bending moment at the point C, right? For that, what I need to do? First, I need to keep all the loads on the left part and bring one by one load on the right side. Say, when all the loads are on the left side, definitely the maximum average load on the left side will be more. Then the average has no load on the right side. Then make the 100 kN load to cross this section. 100 kN load to cross the section. Is it alright? When 100 kN load crosses the section C, that time, what is the average load on the right part, left part and on the right part? Left part, three loads are there. 80, 150 and 120. Therefore, it is 80, 150, 120 divided by 11. And on the right side, it is 100 divided by 9. Therefore, what you are going to get? 31.88 is greater than 11.11. What is the meaning of it? The average load on the right part, left part is greater than the right part. Yes. Now you continue. What you are doing? Now you make this 120 to cross the point C. If 120 kilonewton crosses the point C, 120 kilonewton crosses the point C, then what is the average load on the part BC? Average load on the part BC is equal to 120 plus 100. 120 plus 100. That is 120 plus 100 divided by 9. Right, and average load on the left side, average load on the left side, average load on the left side will become equal to, yes, 180 plus 150 plus 80 divided by 11. Now what happens when this load 120 kilonewton, when 120 crosses the load, when 120 kN crosses the section, what happens? The sign of the change, the average load on left and right changes. Are you getting what you mean by the change in sign? Here you see, here it is greater, left is greater than the right, and here the right is greater than the left. When this particular sequence occurs, the load which makes this change is 120 kN. 120 kN is to be kept at the C to get the maximum bending moment. So, actually this problem is incomplete. I will complete it for more clearance to you. See, the first condition is you want the maximum bending moment. You want the maximum bending moment at distance of 6 meter, you have tried for it. You got the fact that when 120 kilonewton, when 150 kilonewton load is at sea, you are getting the maximum bending moment. When 150 kilonewton load is at sea, you are getting the maximum bending moment.